Good morning. Today we'll see about our second unit, and our second unit is transient analysis of basic RL, RC, and RLC circuit. So transient analysis, these are nothing but the changes with respect to the time for RL circuit, RC circuit, and RLC circuit. This is our syllabus. Please mute yourself, Malti. Okay. This is our syllabus. We have to study for RL, RC, or RLC circuit. Ke liye. These are our outlines. What we have to see in our second unit of the electrical circuit. Firstly, we will see today for RL and the RC circuit. We will wait for other students for just 1 minute. At that, we will revise our previous session. In previous session, we have studied our first unit, and in first unit we have seen laws of basic circuit analysis and the voltage laws to derive the value of unknown voltage and to derive the value of unknown current. KCL states that at any node incoming current is equal to the outgoing current. KVL states that algebraic summation of potential difference across every element for any closed loop will be zero. Then we have seen node analysis to derive the value of unknown voltage, and we have to use their KCL. Then we have studied about the mesh analysis. In mesh analysis, we can derive the value of unknown current by using the KVL. And if the value of known current in between the closed loop, then we can call this as a super mesh. Then we have seen about the superposition. If there are lots of energy sources, then we have to calculate the value of current flowing because of every energy source individually. And then we have to take summation of current flowing because of each and every energy sources. Then we have seen about the Thevenin and the Norton's theorem. In Thevenin theorem, if there is any linear complicated network, then we can convert complicated network into simplified Thevenin equivalent circuit, where we will get one voltage source and there will be one resistance that will be in series with that voltage, and load resistance we will take as it is. Then we have studied about the Norton's. Norton's is exactly similar with a Thevenin theorem, but instead of voltage source, we will get here current source. And instead of resistance in series, we will get here resistance that will be in parallel with a current source. Thevenin equivalent ka jo value rehta hai, resistance ka, wo same rahega. Sirf yahan pe hume current derive karna hai, aur Thevenin mein hum kya karte the? Voltage derive karte the. We have studied about source transformation, source shifting. Source shifting means we can convert voltage source into the current source. रेजिस्टेंस का वैल्यू सेम ही रहेगा, बट वोल्टेज के साथ जो रेजिस्टेंस सीरीज में था वो हमें करंट सोर्स में क्या होगा, करंट के साथ वो सेम वैल्यू ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस वी विल गेट इन पैरेलल. देन वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द मैक्सिमम पावर ट्रांसफर थ्योरम. मैक्सिमम पावर विल बी डिलीवर्ड टू द लोड व्हेन द वैल्यू ऑफ लोड रेजिस्टेंस विल बी इक्वल टू द थेवेनिन इक्विवेलेंट रेजिस्टेंस. मतलब RTH इक्वल टू RL रहेगा तो वहां पे क्या होगा, हमें मैक्सिमम पावर मिलेगा. देन वी हैव स्टडीड हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द मैक्सिमम पावर एट द लोड, एंड वी आर यूजिंग द फॉर्मूला पावर इक्वल टू VL स्क्वायर अपॉन 4 RTH, बिकॉज देयर आर टू रेजिस्टेंस RTH और RL रहता है. दैट्स व्हाई वी विल गेट फॉर्मूला VTH स्क्वायर अपॉन 4 RTH और RL, बोथ आर हैविंग द सेम. इन दिस सेशन वी हैव टू स्टडी अबाउट द RL circuit, RC, and RLC circuit. Now we can start our today's session. So we know about the resistor, inductor, and capacitor. Resistor means what? Resistor, this is the passive component and it is used in electronic circuit to oppose the flow of current. Matlab जो एक्सेस करंट है उसको वो अपोज करेगा, सारा करंट नहीं, बट विच विल रिक्वायर दैट विल अलाउ टू फ्लो ओनली दैट अमाउंट ऑफ करंट, एंड इट विल अपोज द एक्सेस अमाउंट ऑफ करंट. इट मींस व्हाट, रेजिस्टर रिप्रेजेंट्स गिवन अमाउंट ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस इन अ सर्किट. किसको रेजिस्टेंस है, ये करंट को. सो रेजिस्टर इज resistance is a measure of how the flow of electric current is opposed. Matlab current kaise opposed ho raha hai. And we can define the value of resistance according to the Ohm's law. Ohm's law says that resistance equal to voltage upon current. Matlab R equal to V by R. We will get. We know about the resistance. Here we have to see about capacitor and the inductor. So firstly, we will see about the inductor. This is the symbolic structure for the inductor. So inductor represents the amount of inductance in a circuit. Resistor kya karta hai? Amount of resistance circuit mein kitna hai. So inductor kya karega? It will define the amount of inductance in a circuit. Inductance is nothing but it is the ability of a component. It is the ability of a component to generate electromagnetic force due to the change in flow of current. जैसे जैसे करंट में चेंज होगा वैसे वहां पे जितना इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक फोर्स क्रिएट होता है दैट विल बी डिफाइंड बाय यूजिंग दिस इंडक्टेंस एंड वी कैन डिनोट इंडक्टेंस बाय यूजिंग कैपिटल एल लेटर. जैसे हम रेजिस्टर के लिए कैपिटल आर यूज करते हैं वैसे हम इंडक्टर के लिए एल यूज करते हैं. अ सिंपल इंडक्टर इज मेड अप ऑफ लूपिंग अ वायर इनटू अ कॉइल. ये कॉइल लाइक स्ट्रक्चर दिख रहा है. तो हम ये कैसे बनाते हैं? बाय यूजिंग द वायर इनटू अ कॉइल. एंड इंडक्टर्स आर यूज्ड इन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सर्किट्स, इलेक्ट्रिकल सर्किट टू रिड्यूस और टू अपोज द चेंज इन इलेक्ट्रिक करंट. जो इलेक्ट्रिक करंट में चेंज होता है दैट विल बी अपोज्ड बाय यूजिंग दिस इंडक्टर. सो इन डीसी सर्किट इंडक्टर लुक्स लाइक अ, इफ यू सी, ये यदि हम यहाँ के कॉइल को हटा देंगे so how will it will look like? It will look like a wire. It means what? It will look like a short circuit. It has no effect when current is constant. क्योंकि ये क्या करता है? इंडक्टर क्या करता है? करंट के जो चेंज, करंट में जो चेंज होता है, it will oppose to that amount. So here, if the value of current is constant, then there is no effect of inductance. And if current is changing in a AC circuit में क्या होता है? Current will change. So if the value of current is changing, then in AC circuit there is an effect of inductor on the electric current. It will oppose to the change in electric current. Now we will study about if there is a circuit in which we have to calculate the voltage and we have to calculate the current. Just because of this inductor. तो ओहम्स लॉ हम किसके लिए यूज करते हैं? जब हमारे पास रेजिस्टर है तो रेजिस्टर की वजह से जो करंट फ्लो हो रहा है, we know according to the Ohm's law, V equal to IR. If you calculate the amount of current, so how will you get? Current equal to V by R. We will get. So if there is a inductor, then we have to find the voltage and current relation for the inductor. Then what, how we can calculate? If we have to define the value of voltage, then we can define V of t equal to L into di upon dt. Because ye kya karta hai? Jo current mein changes hota hai with respect to time, that will be opposed by using the inductor. That we, just because of this reason, if we have to find the voltage, then we can take it is as a L into derivative of current. If you want to find out the current, then we are supposed to take here integration. तो हमें ये I का value मिल जाएगा. ये equation हमें, this is the standard equation which we will get from the property of inductor, because inductor will oppose to the change in flow of current. So if we have to derive the value of current, then we can integrate these equations. और इंटीग्रेशन डेरिवेशन तुमको मैथ्स में पता ही है कि कैसे करना है. तो वी विल टेक हियर इंटीग्रेशन. इफ यू आर टेकिंग इंटीग्रेशन यू विल गेट द इक्वेशंस लाइक आई ऑफ टी. टी इज नथिंग बट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू टाइम. टाइम मीन्स व्हाट? हियर वी आर टेकिंग द इनिशियल कंडीशंस. दैट्स व्हाई हियर वी आर कॉलिंग दीज आर द ट्रांजिएंट एनालिसिस, बिकॉज वी हैव टू कंसिडर हियर इनिशियल टाइम, Then we have to consider here how much time is required before switching, after switching. Matlab, if we are giving a time and at that time there is a switch position get changed, then we can call t equal to 0. And the instant before the switching, we can define this time as t of 0 upper suffix minus, matlab before switching, or t of 0 uske upar yadi hum plus de rahe, so we can call it is the time just after the changing the position for switch. And if we are taking time infinite or higher, then it is the all instants happen after the switching. Matlab switching ke baad jitne bhi changes honge, if you are giving t equal to infinite or t equal to greater than 0, or ye 0 minus kya ho raha hai, it is the before switching. And if you are taking 0 plus, to yahan usko kya bolenge hum, the time or the instant after switching. So here we can derive the value of voltage by using the inductor property. We will get V of t equal to L into di upon dt. And with respect to time, that's why we are taking here time, and we are taking here derivative with respect to time. If you are integrating these equations, you will get the equations for current. And if you solve these equations with respect to time, this is the time before switching, this is the time at the switching, and this is the time after switching takes place. Matlab jo time switch karne, jab tum switch ko close kar rahe ho, uske baad jo bhi instant honge usko hum kya karenge, ye we can denote as t equal to greater than 0, or we can take it is as a t, and we can call this as a before switching na, kyunki ye 0 se pehle ka hai, so we can take it is the current before switching, and we can take it is as it is, because these are the things which we will get after the switching. Now we will see the characteristics of the inductor or the property. There is no voltage across an inductor if current through it is not changing with time. Matlab, if there is a DC circuit, we can consider inductor as a short circuit. It means what? Jab wahan pe voltage ka value, current ka value change hi nahi ho raha hai, current ka value change hi nahi hoga, so there will be no voltage. So we can consider inductor as a short circuit for DC circuit. And if there is a AC circuit, there is a changing in current, then there will be potential drop, then there will be voltage will be created across the inductor. Aur yadi wahan pe DC hai, to DC ko ye kya karega, we will consider here as a short circuit. We can consider here inductor as a wire. A finite amount of energy can be stored in the inductor even if voltage across inductor is 0, such as when current flowing through inductor is constant. Matlab yadi wahan pe voltage nahi hai, hum kya bol rahe hain, yadi current ka value constant hai, so there will be no potential drop. But even there is a potential drop, then there is a finite small amount of energy will be stored in a inductor, because inductor will oppose the change in flow of current, and inductor is having ability to generate the electromagnetic force. It is possible to change the current through inductor by finite amount in zero time. Matlab time mein yadi thoda sa change hoga, zero time matlab minor, for this we will require infinite voltage across the inductor. Hum kya bol rahe hain ki voltage ka value zero rahega kab, wahan pe current yadi flow hi nahi ho raha hai. But it is impossible to change in current by finite amount of zero time, because for this we will require infinite voltage. If there is a voltage, it means what? If there is a AC supply, matlab at that time there will be change in current. But yadi voltage hai hi nahi, to wahan pe current mein change hi nahi hai, matlab ho hi nahi sakta, because if there is a no amount of voltage. So we require to change in current higher amount of voltage, because inductor will resist abrupt changes in current flowing through it, analogous to the way in which MOS reverses the abrupt change in velocity. जैसे हम physics में बोलते हैं कि velocity को क्या करता है, MOS क्या करता है? It will reverse abrupt change. Like this, if we have to change the current of inductor, then we will require infinite amount of the voltage. These are the properties of inductor. क्योंकि हमें यहाँ पे RL सर्किट को थरोली पढ़ना है, उसकी वजह से हम इंडक्टर का वोल्टेज के साथ रिलेशन कैसा है और करंट के साथ रिलेशन कैसा है. सो इफ देयर इज नो अमाउंट ऑफ करंट चेंजेस, मतलब वहां पे करंट का वैल्यू कांस्टेंट है, देन देयर विल बी नो वोल्टेज. एंड इफ वी वांट टू चेंज द अमाउंट ऑफ करंट, देन वी रिक्वायर इनफिनाइट अमाउंट ऑफ वोल्टेज अक्रॉस द इंडक्टर. Inductor never dissipates energy, but only it stores the energy. वो क्या करता है? Energy को store करता है. Although this is true for mathematically, but practically it is not true because it is having finite series resistance. और जैसे resistance होता है तो वो क्या करता है? Oppose करता है. So it will dissipate energy. मतलब ideally we are saving, inductor never dissipate, but practically it is not true, there will be some amount of dissipations just because of the finite series resistance. These are the properties of inductor, and these are the mathematically equations for voltage and current for the inductor. Now we will study about the capacity. We are denoting capacitor by using the C, capital C letter, and we can draw capacitor by using one standing line and one curved line. If we are supposed to calculate the value of voltage and current, then we are supposed to know the properties of capacitor. As inductor represent the amount of inductance, रेजिस्टेंस जो होता है वो क्या करता है? इट विल रिप्रेजेंट द अमाउंट ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस इन द इलेक्ट्रिकल एंड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सर्किट. सो कैपेसिटर विल रिप्रेजेंट द अमाउंट ऑफ कैपेसिटेंस इन द सर्किट. एंड कैपेसिटेंस इज नथिंग बट इट इज द एबिलिटी ऑफ अ कंपोनेंट टू स्टोर इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज. ये क्या करता है? इलेक्ट्रिकल चार्ज स्टोर करता है. So we are using capacitor to store the electric charges. The capacitance is defined by C equal to, you have definitely studied about the capacitor inductor in diploma also. We know if we want to find the value of capacitance mathematically with respect to charge and voltage, how we can define? C equal to Q by V. C equal to Q by V. But we can write Q equal to, हमें पता है, if we are taking dQ by dt, we will get current. तो हम यदि उसका integration लेंगे, तो तुमको क्या मिलेगा? Value of Q you will get. dQ by dt को हम क्या करते हैं? Current लेते हैं. So in this way, we are getting C equal to Q by V. This is nothing but Q means charge and V means velocity. Charge will be measured in coulomb and V will be measured in voltage. So you will get C equal to Q by V, and dQ by dt will nothing but it is the current, rate of change of flow charges with respect to time will be current. So here if we are supposed to derive the value of current, you will get हियर आई ऑफ टी इक्वल टू, हमें क्या है? सी इंटू क्यू मिलता है. सो इफ यू सॉल्व दिस इक्वेशन, जो सी इक्वल टू क्यू बाई वी है, इफ यू सॉल्व दिस इक्वेशन यू विल गेट हियर आई ऑफ टी इक्वल टू सी इंटू डी वी बाय डी टी. दिस आर एग्जैक्टली ऑपोजिट फॉर इंडक्टर एंड कैपेसिटर. इंडक्टर में क्या था? हमें करंट चाहिए तो वी हैव टू टेक 1 बाय एल एंड इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ वोल्टेज. बट यहाँ पे हमें क्या है, करंट का इक्वेशन हाउ विल यू गेट, यू विल गेट सी इंटू डी आई बाई डी टी. यहाँ पे एल इंटू डी वी बाई डी टी था. दिस आर द एग्जैक्टली ऑपोजिट relations for current and voltage for capacitor and the inductor. If you are supposed to calculate I of t, then you will get I of t, matlab current with respect to time will be C into dv by dt. And if you are supposed to find the value of voltage, you are supposed to take here integration. Aur yahan pe uska integration loge to tumhe milega 1 by C minus infinity to t integration I of t dt. And if you solve, you will get V of t equal to V of 0 minus, this is nothing but the voltage before switching and the voltage after switching. It will be calculated as 1 by C integration from 0 to t I of t dt. These are the voltage and current relationship for the capacitor. Now we will see about the properties. So there is no current through the capacitor if voltage across is not changing with time. वहाँ पे क्या था? If current will not change, inductor के लिए क्या था? If current will not change, then there will be no potential drop. और यहाँ पे क्या है? यदि voltage change नहीं हो रहा है, तो वहाँ पे current zero रहेगा. These are exactly opposite relations for current and voltage. यदि तुम कैपेसिटर और इंडक्टर को कंपेयर करोगे तो वहां पे जो वोल्टेज का इक्वेशन मिल रहा था वो यहाँ हमें करंट के लिए मिलता है, और जो करंट के लिए था वो हमें यहाँ पे वोल्टेज के लिए मिलता है. सो देयर इज नो अमाउंट ऑफ करंट फ्लोइंग थ्रू द कैपेसिटर इफ द वोल्टेज अक्रॉस इज इट नॉट चेंजिंग. सो वी कैन कंसिडर कैपेसिटर एज अ ओपन सर्किट. और हम इंडक्टर को क्या करते थे, वी कैन कंसिडर इंडक्टर एज अ शॉर्ट सर्किट for the DC. और हम ये DC के लिए capacitor को how will you consider? We'll consider it is as a open circuit. A finite amount of energy can be stored in a capacitor if current flowing through capacitor is zero, such as voltage across it is a constant. मतलब क्या, यहाँ पे यदि उसका वोल्टेज का वैल्यू कॉन्स्टेंट है, then what we are saying, there will be no amount of current flowing through that capacitor. Current ka value zero. But here also there will be finite amount of energy because capacitor will store the charges, and if switch will get off, matlab at that time also it will store energy and that will be used for finite time. That's why there will be finite amount of energy will be stored in a capacitor. It is impossible to change the voltage across capacitor by finite amount in a zero time. For this, we will require infinite current flowing through the capacitor. क्योंकि जब तक यहाँ पे current flow नहीं होगा, तब तक यहाँ पे voltage रहेगा ही. That's why it is impossible to change the value of voltage across the capacitor. We require infinite current flowing through the capacitor to change the amount of voltage. Capacitor will resist abrupt change in the voltage across in analogous to the way spring resists a abrupt change in a displacement. जैसे हम उसके लिए इंडक्टर के लिए जैसे हम बोलते थे कि मास क्या करता है, वेलोसिटी को अब्रप्ट करता है. लाइक दिस इफ वी आर टेकिंग वन एग्जांपल, स्प्रिंग विल रेजिस्ट अब्रप्ट चेंज इन अ डिस्प्लेसमेंट. लाइक दिस थिंग्स इफ वी हैव टू चेंज द वैल्यू ऑफ वोल्टेज वी विल रिक्वायर इनफिनाइट अमाउंट ऑफ करंट. एंड इफ देयर इज नो अमाउंट ऑफ करंट देन देयर विल बी, मतलब करंट यदि वहां पे नहीं है, करंट का अमाउंट कॉन्स्टेंट है, देन देयर विल बी नो चेंज इन वोल्टेज. Capacitor never dissipates energy. Capacitor is used to only store the energy. Capacitor क्या करता है? Dissipate नहीं करता है energy को. It is used to store the energy. Although this is true for mathematical model, but practically these things will not happen. practically capacitor also dissipate some amount of energy due to finite amount of resistance associated with dielectric as well as the packaging. Matlab, there will be some amount of power dissipations. So we have to see when we have to consider inductor as short circuit, when we have to consider inductor as open circuit, when we have to consider open and short circuit for the capacitor. If there is any equivalent circuit and we needed to take time after switching, matlab the instant just after the switching and the instant after infinite amount after switching, matlab ek bar tumne switch kar diya uske baad tum jo bhi थोड़े टाइम के लिए नहीं, तुम उसके बाद यदि लॉन्ग टाइम के लिए इफ यू आर डूइंग द चेंजेस एट दैट टाइम हाउ वी हैव टू टेक इंडक्टर एंड कैपेसिटर. फर्स्टली वी विल सी अबाउट द इक्विवेलेंट सर्किट एट टाइम इक्वल टू जीरो प्लस. दीज आर द इनिशियल कंडीशंस वी हैव टू कंसिडर फॉर रेजिस्टर, इंडक्टर एंड कैपेसिटर. इफ देयर इज अ रेजिस्टर, देन वी आर टेकिंग रेजिस्टर एज इट इज. टाइम का कोई यही नहीं है, वी विल टेक रेजिस्टर ऑलवेज एज इट इज बिकॉज वी नो द वैल्यू ऑफ रेजिस्टर इज डिपेंडिंग ऑन वोल्टेज एंड करंट बिकॉज वी नो अकॉर्डिंग टू ओम्स लॉ वी विल गेट वी इक्वल टू आई आर. तो आर का जो इक्वेशन है वी आर गेटिंग वी बाय आर. सो द वैल्यू ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस इज डिपेंडिंग ऑन वोल्टेज एंड करंट. सो वी हैव टू कंसिडर रेजिस्टेंस एज इट इज. बट इफ देयर इज अ इंडक्टर विथ or without initial current, then there will be lots of difference how we have to take inductor. If there is no amount of current initially, at that time if there is inductor, then we have to consider it is as a open circuit. And if there is inductor with some initial amount of current I zero, we are saying ये आई ओ नहीं है, आई जीरो मतलब स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ करंट इनिशियली है. हम जीरो मतलब क्या बोलते हैं, इनिशियल कंडीशन. तो इफ देयर इज अ स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ करंट, देन ये जो इंडक्टर है और उसमें से थोड़ा करंट फ्लो हो रहा है, तो व्हाट वी विल डू, वी विल टेक दिस इंडक्टर एज अ ओपन सर्किट एंड वी विल टेक दिस करंट एज इट इज. सो वी कैन ड्रॉ दिस डायग्राम एज, मतलब ये इंडक्टर को तो हम ओपन कर रहे हैं, तो यहाँ पे ओपन करने की जरूरत नहीं है बिकॉज वी आर टेकिंग ओनली दैट अमाउंट ऑफ करंट विच इज फ्लोइंग विथ इंडक्टर. ये इंडक्टर में से जो करंट जा रहा था वी हैव टू टेक एज इट इज. एंड इफ देयर इज अ कैपेसिटर विदाउट इनिशियल वोल्टेज, तो हम उसको कैपेसिटर को हाउ वी विल टेक, वी विल टेक इट इज एज अ शॉर्ट सर्किट. एंड इफ देयर इज अ स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ वोल्टेज, देन वी विल टेक this circuit as a open circuit and we will take this voltage as it is. ये जो voltage है उसको हम as it is we will take. और voltage जो है we will take this voltage as it is. और ये capacitor है we will take it is as a open circuit. These are the basic things which we have to take in a calculations. Because in exam there will be any electrical circuit where the value of resistor, inductor, amount of voltage, current, they will be given. And one thing will be missing. Matlab, they will give the value of voltage, inductor, capacitor. And you are supposed to calculate the value of current. So, tab tumhe kya karna hai? You are supposed to derive the value of current at instant 0 plus. Matlab, initial condition ke liye. Just after switching. If you are supposed to derive at that time, if there is no amount of current with inductor, then you are supposed to take inductor as a open circuit. Or यदि वहाँ पे current है, you will take as it is that amount of current. Or वहाँ पे यदि capacitor है without initial voltage, then we can take it is as a short circuit. Now we will see about equivalent circuit at t equal to infinite. If we are having any electrical circuit and we are supposed to calculate the value of current after infinite time, matlab long time, if capacitor is not initially changed, then at t equal to infinite we can take capacitor as a open circuit and we have to take resistor as it is and if there is a inductor without initial voltage to hum yahan pe kya kar rahe the we are considering l as a open circuit but after infinite time we have to consider inductor as a short circuit these are exactly opposite chart with this रजिस्टर का है एज इट इज बट बाकी ये जो थिंग्स है दिस विल बी अपोज बिकॉज यहाँ पे वोल्टेज और करंट का रिलेशन कैसे अपोज है वहां पे वोल्टेज करंट पे डिपेंड था और इसमें क्या है इंडक्टर में क्या था करंट का वैल्यू वोल्टेज पे डिपेंड था और कैपेसिटर में क्या है वोल्टेज का वैल्यू करंट पे डिपेंड है दैट्स व्हाई हियर वी आर गेटिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ वोल्टेज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ वहां पे हमें क्या थे डेरिवेटिव के फॉर्म में मिल रहे थे बट यहाँ पे हमें करंट का इक्वेशन डेरिवेटिव के फॉर्म में मिलता है दैट्स व्हाई If there is an inductor without initial current, we have to take it as a short circuit. And if there is small amount of current, then we have to take this current in parallel with this short circuit. And if there is a capacitor without initial charge or without initial voltage, then we can take this capacitor as a open circuit. यहाँ पे हम capacitor को short circuit ले रहे थे. And if there is a small amount of initial voltage, with this capacitor, then we have to take this voltage as it is, and we have to take here this capacitor as a open circuit. ये capacitor को हम क्या करेंगे? Open circuit लेंगे यहाँ पे. We will see one example. If we are having here one switch, we are having two resistors. We are having here inductor, we are having capacitor, we are having here voltage also. मतलब energy sources दिए हैं, voltage के value दिए हैं, resistor, inductor के values दिए हैं. This is the RLC circuit, RLC circuit because here capacitor also. And what we have to do? We have to calculate loop current. मतलब we have to find I1 current and we have to find I2 current with respect to t. So we can consider here. This time as 0+ because they have not given here the time infinite time they have not given you are supposed to calculate the value of current just after the switching so we can take this t equal to 0+ so we know if we are taking here capacitor what we have to do we have to consider this capacitor as a We have to consider this capacitor as a open circuit. Firstly, if we are taking this diagram, then we have to consider it is a short circuit, not a open circuit. See here, what we have to do? We have to find the loop current. और उन्होंने क्या है RLC सर्किट दिया है. तो हमने देखा है हमारा चार्ट. उसमें हम क्या करते हैं? If there is a small amount of time after switching then we have to consider inductor as a open circuit and we have to consider capacitor as a short circuit to hum ye capacitor ko how will you take we will take it is a short circuit resistor we will take as it is we will take resistor as it is and inductor we can take as a open circuit yadi hum second loop dekh rahe hain to ye open hai to ye current ka value jo rahega it will be can anyone tell me open circuit ke liye yahan pe sirf resistor hai yahan pe baki voltage source voltage battery di hui nahi hai yahan pe sirf ek resistor hai ek yahan pe capacitor hai but this circuit is open to yahan pe I2 ka value there will be some amount of current or the value of current will be zero because we are considering this inductor as a open circuit to mujhe koi batayega ki ye current ka value zero rahega yahan pe या ये वहां पे कोई अमाउंट रहेगा क्या नहीं मैं टेल मी स्नेहा आंसर द क्वेश्चन माय स्क्रीन इज विजिबल टू यू स्नेहा एम आई ऑडिबल
यस मैम
हाँ तो ये जो सेकेंड सर्किट है इसमें इंडक्टर जो है वी आर कंसीडरिंग इट इज एज अ ओपन सर्किट यहाँ पे रेजिस्टर है यहाँ पे कैपेसिटर है इफ यू आर अप्लाइंग केवीएल व्हाट विल हैपन वैल्यू ऑफ करंट हियर So just tell me the value of current will be zero or there will be some amount of current. Open circuit में current का value क्या होता है? We will get here zero current. क्योंकि यहाँ पे battery दी ही नहीं है. You can mute yourself. Okay. So here you will get the value of current as a zero ampere. Now we are supposed to find for loop one. तो हम KVL apply करते हैं. तो हम क्या करते हैं यहाँ पे? We will consider for this capacitor. ये दोनों के बीच है ना? ये दोनों जो loop है, उसके बीच है. तो what we have to consider? I1 and we have to consider I2 also. And how we have to consider? I1 we will consider positive and I2 we will consider negative. But यहाँ पे जो है, यहाँ पे I2 का value zero है. तो हमें इसको consider करने की जरूरत ही नहीं है. So now we will focus on our first loop. If you see in first loop, we are having the value of resistor and we will consider this switch as a closed switch because after switch close, we are supposed to calculate the value of loop current. Unhone wahan pe diya hai, switch is closed. So what we have to do? We have to consider it is a closed switch. We are having the value of voltage. We are having the value of current. So hume KVL apply karne ki zarurat hi nahi hai. Directly we will get the value. I1 of t equal to V by R. You will get 10 by 1. So you will get here 10 ampere. So if you are solving this RLC circuit, you will get I1 of t equal to 10 ampere and you are getting I2 of t equal to 0 ampere because we are supposed to calculate the value of loop current when switch will close at the time 0. This is nothing but here we can consider no initial conditions for inductor and capacitor. क्योंकि उन्होंने यहाँ पे वोल्टेज और करंट के इनिशियली वैल्यूज दिए हैं, नहीं दिए हैं. ये जो इंडक्टर है उसमें से इनिशियल का करंट नहीं दिया है. ये जो कैपेसिटर है उसमें का इनिशियल वोल्टेज नहीं दिया है. सो देयर आर नो इनिशियल कंडीशंस फॉर इंडक्टर एंड कैपेसिटर. सो आफ्टर स्विचिंग द क्लोज वी कैन टेक रेजिस्टर एज इट इज एंड वी कैन कंसिडर कैपेसिटर एज अ शॉर्ट सर्किट एंड वी कैन कंसिडर दिस इंडक्टर एज अ ओपन सर्किट. जैसे हमने देखा वी हैव टू कंसिडर दिस ओपन सर्किट. सो दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल हाउ वी हैव टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ करंट और वैल्यू ऑफ वोल्टेज इन RLC and RC circuit. Now in next session we have to study about the source free circuit. We will see in next class. Now I am taking your attendance. If anyone is facing any issue, you can ask me. Now you guys can leave now. Thank you.